Coming up next, In Your Dreams.
Hello, everyone. It's a great day today. You're listening to In Your Dreams. I'm your host, God's Girl. And In Your Dreams is a Christian dream interpretation show. And it's so good to be with you again today. I've got some exciting news to tell you, but I can't tell you just right yet. First, I need to tell you, Dawn called from Florida, and she had a dream about a train in the darkness. And even though it seemed a little dreary, you know what? It really was an encouraging dream. And last, we have Anne. We're going to talk about her dream. She lives in the UK, and you know what? As I share her dream with you, guess what? Prophetess Ethel Martin is going to be on the show today. Isn't that exciting? That's the great news I had to tell you. God had words of encouragement for Anne. And so, you know what? God did not forget about you because he was faithful. He was showing off in this show. Vision after vision after vision came. So be sure to stay tuned because there may be a word from the Lord for you today from Prophetess Ethel Martin. God bless you. Stay tuned. It's dream time. Hello, Dawn, and thank you for calling In Your Dreams.
Hi, how are you?
Fine, how are you?
It's great.
I'm so honored, really honored to have you on the show tonight. I appreciate you being a guest. Okay, so why don't you tell us your dream?
Okay, well, the dream started, I was in a two-story house, and in the house a woman came in to the room, and her name was Counselor. And we sat around on the floor, there was a bunch of Christians in there, and we sat around the floor and we were listening to her speak. Then the dream changed and I was still in the house and my husband was there. And then I looked out the window to my left and what I saw were people running in the street and they were screaming and trying to get away. And what was happening was there was black fog rolling in, and it was rolling in all over the earth.
Really?
Yeah.
Not just the neighborhood, but all over the earth?
Yeah, and we had the sense that it was all over the earth.
Okay.
And so my husband and I were sad about this and upset, and we went to the refrigerator. And in the refrigerator, I took out my cell phone and my charger.
I keep mine in theirs, too.
You do?
Yeah. I'm just kidding.
Keep them fresh. Okay. And then it changed again in the dream, and I looked out another window, which was on my right side, and I saw a train coming down the track, and it was actually coming alongside of our house, and the train was very slow moving, but it was wobbly on the tracks, and I wondered if it was going to stay on the track. And then the dream changed again in the same house, and my husband and I were in the living room, and he was sitting on the couch, and there was a woman sitting next to him, and I was on my knees between both of them. And she began to pray for us, and she was holding us very closely, very tight with her arms. And she began to pray for us for healing. And then suddenly, while she was praying, I felt like such a rush going through my body. I'm not sure what it was, like a power or something.
Right.
And then I got up and went to the kitchen sink, and then I woke up.
And when did you have this dream?
It was about a month ago.
Really?
Yeah.
Hopefully you can remember what went on in your life a month ago. Do you know anything about dream interpretation?
Not really. I mean, I have a lot of dreams. Sometimes they come in threes. I have them 3 days in a row, 3 nights in a row, and then I won't have any for a week, but I have studied some dream books, and I do try to get in the books and try and figure out, well, you know, biblically what
right.
these words mean.
Right.
But it, for me, it's just confusing. You know, it's just
yeah. Yeah, because there are no ironclad rules. There's
no,
very
no,
few
ironclad. One thing might mean something to you,
right.
which is a little different. You know, it could mean something totally different to me.
Right, right. Very yeah. good. Okay, well, let me ask you this. A month ago when you had this dream, you said in the dream when you were speaking that you and your husband felt very sad.
Yeah.
That this black fog was rolling in all over the earth. I think we would agree that whatever the black fog is, it's not good, correct?
No, it's not good.
Because there was a panic, right? People were running.
There was a panic and there was more like a dread of something.
A dread.
Yeah.
Okay, so what were you sad about in your life a month ago?
It could be, I was diagnosed with breast cancer.
Oh, that would be a black fog.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, and I've been going through this almost 2 months now, so it possibly could have been that.
And so you and your husband, was your husband in the house at the beginning when the counselor came in?
No, I didn't see him there, no.
So it was just you?
Yeah, it was just me. Actually, when the counselor came in, there was other Christian brothers and sisters in the house. And as this counselor came in, we all sat on the floor because she was beginning to speak. And I guess counselor.
Right. Well, do you feel like maybe the counselor in the dream... first of all, let me ask you this. Did you recognize the house that you were in?
No, I've never been in the house.
So this wasn't a house that you live in today?
No.
Because...
No. We do live in a townhouse, and it is two stories, but this house in the dream was not it.
Okay, but it was two-story, like your townhouse.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so you didn't reckon, when the lady came in, what part of the house were you in?
The living room.
Okay, because I know in the latter part you said you were in the living room, but I just didn't know when she came in, and you sat on the floor.
Mm-hmm.
Well, did it have a church feel to it? Did you, the people that were in there, the Christians,
yes.
Did they feel like they were from your church?
Yeah, but I didn't know any of them.
So it was just a Christ-centered
mm-hmm.
situation. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, could there be anything else that you were sad about? Maybe are you married?
Mm-hmm.
With your husband or anything?
Yeah, it could be. I mean, our marriage kind of goes up and down. We have a lot of issues.
Right, because
I do.
Based on the dream... looking at it, I think it's more relationship than the breast cancer.
Mm-hmm.
I'll tell you why. These were some ideas I had as I listened to your dream. You said, I had a dream that I was in a two-story house and a woman came in and her name was Counselor. Okay, do you feel like you and your husband need any counseling?
Sometimes we do, and actually we have a pastor that we go. He's actually a Christian counselor.
Okay.
So we've been to him several times.
Is he gentle?
Yeah, he's gentle.
Because some women, I'm very domineering.
Mm-hmm.
And so a lot of times in dreams when you have people that show up, if he's a gentle man and a real humble man, he might show up being a little bit, that might be why he showed up as a feminine counselor.
Mm-hmm.
But if you have someone that's like me, a little bit more on the masculine side,
right.
When I dream about my life and my rededication time, I have an 11-year-old boy show up in my dream that's representing me. So that's possibly why it could be a woman. Okay. And it said that it just appears that you're sitting on the floor. You're in a place where you're willing to listen.
Right.
And if it's a Christian environment, it could represent Christian counseling. Now I'm just throwing some ideas at you.
Yeah, I'm open.
Yeah, okay, good. Okay. And then it says you looked out the window and you saw people running in the street to try to get away. Do you feel like there's maybe like a I don't know, like your marriage is sometimes gonna end?
Sometimes I do, yeah.
Because
we've been close to that point, yeah, a few times.
Because the feeling was dread and sadness.
Mm-hmm.
And the ending of your dream is very good, but the thing that I thought was unique was when you said that you were in a two-story house.
Mm-hmm.
This is kind of a play on words. Is there, if it's in your marriage, is there times when maybe he has a story and you have a story?
Yeah. It's always...
You see what I'm
excited,
saying?
You know, there's always something he's got, and then there's a story on my side.
And I think that's why the dream showed it was a two-story house.
Oh,
it's a pun on words. It's not really about the levels. It's about there's two stories, your story and his story. Okay, and I felt like the Holy Spirit showed me that earlier. But you have the final say, so. Okay, so let's just say we're talking about your relationship. And then we come in, we have this black fog moving, which can be dread and sadness because, you know, you're in this counseling situation. And that's true in real life, right?
Right.
You're
being
counseled at times by your pastor.
Right.
And you said you took out your cell phone and your charger and it was out of the refrigerator.
Right.
Okay, to me, this is just an idea and only you know your heart. But are there times when your communication freezes up or gets cold?
Oh, yeah.
Because the cell phone being in the refrigerator, cell phone can either represent prayer, again,
I never thought about that.
Are you getting an aha?
Yeah.
Okay, good. A cell phone or can either represent prayer or can represent communication, and you stuck that in the refrigerator. You kind of stored it away. But when you really needed it, you pulled out. You decided to talk, to get some help, to call because of this overwhelming dread and this sadness and what was going on in your neighborhood,
right,
of where you live. Okay, and if it's over the whole earth, that just might just mean that it was overwhelming, you know, taking over your whole being,
right,
and kind of maybe hopeless, you know, like it was the end of the world.
Right.
And if you're married and you love your husband, it can be the end of the world. If you're thinking that that's not going to work out, it's the end of the world as you know it.
Mm-hmm.
You know? So you think we're on the right track so far?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, good. Okay, so it says, then I looked out another window and I saw, you said you saw a train coming down the tracks right next to the window, and it was moving slow. This is the train, and it was very wobbly.
Right.
And then my husband and I were in a living room of this house, and my husband sat on the couch, and a woman was next to him, and I was on my knees, and between them she had a hold of both of us with her arms, and she was praying very hard for us for healing. And I felt such a rush, I got up and went to the kitchen sink, and then I woke. All right, so we're at the place, we've walked through the dream so far, we're at the place where you're looking out the other window. Now, you told me when you were just speaking that we looked out to the window, it was to the right.
Right.
Okay. Do you have any mental impressions or heart impressions on what's right and what's left?
Yeah.
Okay. What's right to you?
What's right to me?
Yeah, on your right side.
Mm.
In the dream, you looked out the right window.
Mm-hmm. But that was the train.
Okay, yeah. You saw the train, but versus... I used to have a friend who thought he was half angel. This is going to sound really deep. I led him to the Lord. I led him back to the Lord. But his right side meant the world, and his left side meant spiritual.
Hmm.
So in the Bible,
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
In the Bible, the Bible says that Jesus sits at the right hand of the Father.
Right.
Okay. And so Jesus or the church would be at the right hand side, or the body of Christ, which we are the church.
Right.
We are his body. And then the left side of Jesus would be the Father, which is the Spirit. Now, I'm just giving you ideas. But, so it said you went to the right. Do you feel like the right could have been the church? Could be the
probably.
Church for you. It could be Jesus, whatever it is. You went
the
out
right is always the good. You know, the right is always something,
Okay, so to you, the right is good. So you looked out a good window. We'll put good in there because you said it was the right window, right?
Right.
You looked out the good window, and it would make sense because if you looked out the other window and you saw a black fog, that would be the bad window.
Right.
So you looked out the good window, okay? Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, I'm a little congested. But you looked out the good window because right means good to you. You saw a train coming down the tracks right next to the window, and it was moving slow and very wobbly.
Right.
All right, now, what is a train to you?
A train, well, I don't know. Sometimes a train could be, of course, a train is continuous. You know?
You've been reading Ira Milligan's book.
Yeah. A train is continuous. You know, something that's moving all the time.
Right.
The track possibly could be something. My life, you know, my life is wobbly.
Well,
my spiritual life is wobbly.
Or it could be possibly. Now, do you feel that really in your heart, or do you just think that that's the only thing you can come up with from the book?
Well, I do feel it in my heart that my spiritual walk sometimes is very wobbly.
Okay.
I try to stay on the track, but sometimes I wobble back and forth, you know, but I'm trying to speak because of the issues that I'm dealing with in my life and the issues that my husband and I deal with.
Right.
We kind of go around this thing over and over again.
Right.
You know, so, yeah.
Okay. Well, that's good because do you feel like your spiritual life is connected to church? Do you feel like you're wobbly when it comes to church? Like your attendance or... because the train is a man-made structure.
Mm-hmm.
And even though that we know that Jesus built the church and upon his rock, you know, the church won't be moved and it will prevail. Right. It's still an organization of men, you know, and so the train can either represent, I don't know if it would represent your life, because I believe the house that you're in represents your life. Because usually a house will represent a place where your soul's at. Okay. So could it be possible that, let me ask you this, and you can answer the same thing, or you might, just based on the way that I put it, I might trigger something different. Mm-hmm. What do you feel that is good that you're looking at, and you're kind of foreseeing it slow down, not have much fuel, and it looks a little wobbly, and it looks like it might get off track?
Well, that could be the marriage.
That's what I was thinking too. And you're the, you know, you have the final say, so. But it, I think the train could represent the marriage, because it's like you said, it is continuous, and it, you know, it's a man-made in the sense that God puts us together in the spirit, but we also go through a legal action on this earth as far as taking our vows. And you know, it's this man-made unit that, you know, that the spiritual, we don't understand how the two become one, but, you know, in the law, you know, the two become one, and it's something that we do. So that's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking maybe your marriage might be a little low on steam, and it might be a little wobbly, and it supports. See, this last part, it's not talking about the church, because the focus of the dream is about you and your husband. It's about your soul and where you live at, and the counseling that's going on. So if the train does represent your marriage, then it's another clue to support the dream as a whole. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, I see it now. And, you know, it's the funniest thing. I never thought of it that way, but it witnesses to me.
Good, good. And you're the final say-so.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, but the great thing about your dream is that even though that's the storyline, okay, is that at the end, you said that after this woman prayed for you, it could be the pastor, prayers of your pastor, it could be the Holy Spirit working in you through the prayer. After this work in prayer is done, at one point during this time, a month ago, you got a rush, and you got, you know, your marriage got a jolt, because your husband was there with you.
Right.
And so all of a sudden you got up and you went to the kitchen sink. What does a kitchen sink mean to you?
Cleansing?
Well, to me, if I'm standing in front of the kitchen sink, I'm doing dishes, it's work.
Yeah.
So you got up, young lady, and you went to work. You went to work on your marriage.
Okay.
Is that true?
Yeah.
Have you been working on it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Hasn't been easy, but yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. It hasn't been easy, but yeah, it's still a struggle.
Right, and it always will be.
Down.
You know, I mean, it always will be, in the sense that, you know, you're two different people and you're married.
Right.
And I'm sure there'll come a time, and hopefully soon, that God will have most of the work done, you know, to where he's repaired whatever's broken. But nevertheless, in the dream, you got up and you went to work.
Yeah. Huh.
If you want to use my symbol.
Yeah, that's interesting. I like that. Yeah.
Yeah, and see, that's why it's really important to have your own symbols, because like I said, when I stand in front of the kitchen sink, I'm not cleansing nothing but the dishes. I'm working.
You're right.
And I don't want to be there, but it's something I got to do, something I got to take care of.
I can see this now. Yeah.
Praise God.
Yeah, this is neat.
That's great.
Yeah.
So do you feel like you know what your dream means?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, I sure do.
Cool,
and, you know,
cool,
I have some
cool
struggles with my dreams, and I write them down. I mean, I've got two book fulls of them. And I go through the dream books, and I never really look at them in that sense. I'm always looking at maybe something.
You're focusing on the symbol.
And the symbol.
And not the, you have to focus on the feeling. You have to focus on the action. You cannot change the storyline.
Yeah.
The way the story is written is in your heart is the way that it is. And you have to focus on the main thing is finding out what part of your life the dream is talking about. But I would encourage you, if you had fun tonight, I know I did. Thank you, God. I would encourage you to listen to the show and, you know, get a feel for other people's dreams that I work with and see how it's done. And I guarantee you probably in no time after listening to the show about 10 or 15 times, you'll have the hang of it. And I would encourage you to get a dream partner. as well, because they can bounce off ideas, you know, and have aspects, and only do it with someone you trust, because you're opening up your heart. And you don't want to tell somebody a secret and then they, you know, hold it against you. So it is, they are reflections of the heart, and it's almost impossible to have a dream and to be able to hide your heart. And some people, when I talk to them, they're really vague and it's like pulling teeth, but that will get you nowhere. You really have to be open and honest. So do you feel like you know what your dream means?
Yeah, I know what it means now.
Well, thank you for calling In Your Dreams. I hope you enjoyed your interpretation, Dawn. I know it's been a pleasure for me. This is God's Girl. I'm your host. Feel free to call if you have a dream that you'd like to share or something that you'd like interpreted. The area code is 757-495-2058. And thank you for calling.
FYI, everyone. Hey, got some news for you. I get email requests asking about dream books and which ones are good. So if you're interested in checking out the dream book referrals that I have, go check it out on MySpace. Go to www.myspace.com/godsgirltv. Once again, my MySpace webpage is www.myspace.com/godsgirltv, as in television. When you get time, feel free to check it out. I've got book titles on there, authors' names, and their web links. And hey, do these Christian guys a favor. Cut out the middleman and buy it straight from their webpage. And I'm sure they'll appreciate that very much. God bless you, and thanks for checking out MySpace. Hey guys, you're listening to In Your Dreams. I'm your host, God's Girl. Thank you so much for staying tuned in to this part of the segment. Yes, I know what you're thinking. Is this the segment? Yes, 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 it is. Prophetess Ethel Martin is going to be on the phone with us today. And so she's got a word for a caller in particular. The caller that she has a word for, her name is Ann Baker. But God was so awesome that even though we intended just to be a blessing to Ann today, God opened up other visions and revelation for other listeners out there. So there are some of you that, even though we didn't plan on it, the Holy Spirit, He had His own plans, and He has a word for some of the listeners out there. So stay tuned. Even though this appears that we just started it for Anne to be a blessing to her today, God wanted to bless you as well. So before we get with Prophetess Ethel, I have to kind of lay a little bit of a storyline here for you so you can follow how we got to getting to Ethel. What happened was I helped a dreamer with a dream. And like I said, her name was Ann Baker. She lives in the United Kingdom and her husband's unsaved, and Ethel had a word for her, but she wasn't able to call in on the show where people get their words. So I thought, hey, you know, if it was me, I'd want the Lord to find a way to bless me. So what I did was I wrote Ann back, and Ann gave me permission to share her dream, and she also gave me permission to talk about her on air. So I'm not, you know, talking about her behind her back or anything, but so she's listening. Hi, Ann. And she wants to be able to get her word. And the only way that I could really do that was to have Ethel call in and to speak as if we were speaking to her on the phone. But in turn, she's going to get blessed, and you're going to get blessed as well. Okay, so this is the way it happened. I helped Anne with a dream, and in this dream, the dream is what led eventually to the word from the Lord. In this dream, Anne had a dream that she was in a white house, and then she got keys to another white house. The landlord gave her keys to the second white house, which is a bigger white house. And on the setting of this dream, there was the houses were set near the sea, and they were set like there was a cliff environment around. So I was sharing this dream with Ethel, and I don't normally share the dreamer's dreams with Ethel because Ethel is on the show, and I don't like for Ethel to know anything about the dreamers, because I want God to give her revelation without her having any information from me. But there are times with the dreamer's permission, or there are times where if I think it's a special case, I'll share the dream with Ethel. So anyway, I had helped Anne, and I was sharing with Ethel what the interpretation was. But before I could even share with Ethel as far as what I had to say about Anne's dream, God started giving her revelation for Anne in the form of visions. And so I said, wow, this is some good stuff. And it was confirming everything that I had already told Anne. But I said, wow, this is great. You know, Anne needs to get these words. And so, like I said, Anne gave us permission to share her word with her on the air. So what we're doing right now is we're speaking to Anne through the internet. She's going to get the message in the United Kingdom, even though she's not on the line. So these words that are coming forth across the air are new to her. She hasn't heard them yet. So she'll hear them the same time that you hear them. But anyway, in the dream, the houses represented her body, and it represented where she was at in Christ, being righteous. But the key thing of the dream was that, without going into the whole dream and the whole dream interpretation, the key thing of the dream was there was these doors in the house. And when Anne went to open them, before she could even open them, the locks started burning and they kind of disintegrated. Not the doors, but the locks burned up. And so I shared with Anne that I felt like the houses were her, and that the reason why there were two houses was because one was a little bit smaller, the next one was a little bit bigger, which could represent growth, a spiritual growth in her life. The landlord gave her keys to the home, which represented a place that she had authority over. And these doors were places, the doors represent places in her life that had been locked up. Maybe places that she thought that she couldn't go, or places that the enemy had cut her off from, or places that she had shut down herself because of maybe a rest area in her life, meaning she wasn't pursuing those. But nevertheless, the doors were locked. So I told her I felt like the Holy Spirit was the fire. And so when she went to reach for the lock, the fire burned up the locks. I told her, everything you put your hands to, I believe the Lord is going to unlock those doors. Those doors are going to open up for you. Doors that you thought were shut, that the Holy Spirit, his consuming fire, is going to open doors for you that have been locked. Okay? I can't get into the whole dream and the whole dream's interpretation because you'll be lost and I don't remember it to the exact detail. But she emailed me back and said the dream interpretation she felt was right on. She was awestruck. She loved it. She, you know, didn't know how that I knew. So after I relayed to Anne the interpretation of the dream, what I felt God was showing through the dream, she sent me an email thanking me. And so this is what Anne said when she was thanking me. And I'm not doing this to get any credit for myself. I just wanted to just share with you so you can follow. She says, so much of what you said straight away rings crystal clear to me. You couldn't have known that privately God has used houses in my past dreams to represent me in my life. And then she goes on, says she's excited about what God's getting ready to do. And then she says that it's amazing that the interpretation that I relayed to her was so accurate, she says. But anyway, the dream's interpretation was basically centered around her walking into things that have been shut down and doors opening for her that were not open before by the power of the Holy Spirit. Okay. But in balance, I shared with Anne that she needed to, because God uses us. We work together. We co-labor with God. Okay. He uses us in the natural. We have to appropriate the promises. We have to stand on the promises that he gives us. We have to use the word. We have to pray. We have to declare it, and we have to have faith for it. So even though God can do all these great things and open up doors for her, he wants her to come alongside and to start using her power and authority in Christ to declare it, proclaim it, stand. Even when you don't see it happening, still stand, unmovable faith, and watch God change things in her life, things that have been shut down, things that were rocky around her, okay? So that's the gist of the dream and the gist of the interpretation. Now, after that happened and I got that email of her thanking me, that's when I shared with Ethel about her dream and its interpretation. But like I said, I didn't get too far into sharing because God started showing visions and I shut up because I didn't want to tell her any more information because I wanted her to get Ethel her information from the Lord. So this leads us to this part of the show. I said, okay, Ethel, we got to get these visions to Anne. She needs to be encouraged. If it was a word for me, I'd want the word. So I said, Ethel, would you be on the show and just relay the visions that God gave to you so Anne can be blessed all the way in the United Kingdom? I said, she's not able to call in and get these words because her husband wouldn't understand because he is unsaved.
God's Girl will be right back after this short break.
She's not able to call in and get these words because her husband wouldn't understand because he is unsaved. And so before we go on to Miss Ethel, I just want to say right now, I just stand in agreement with you, Anne, Lord, and hopefully the listeners can agree. I just pray, Lord, for Anne's husband, God, and other people out there that have husbands that are unsaved or loved ones, God. Lord, we just pray that you'd send, Father, Lord, laborers in their pathway. Father God, I just ask, God, Lord, that your spirit would hover over them. Lord, that you would just draw them. The word says that no one can come into the Father unless the Father draws them first. So I just ask, God, that you draw them to you, Father. Compel them, God. Woo them to you. In the name of Jesus, give them ears to hear, Father. Lord, let the seeds that have been spoken in their lives a long time ago by passerbys or by pastors that they used to know or by parents that have sown seeds of Christianity and of God's word in their heart. I pray that those seeds would germinate, God, and spring forth in this day and this season and bring forth new life, a reborn again spirit, a love for you in their lives.
today, God, Lord. Do it, God, for your glory and for your honor. And Lord, we just intercede on behalf of them, and we just ask, God, that you would just break them out of their sin and, God, set them free. We command the enemy. We loose them in the name of Jesus. You take your hands off of them. They were created by God, for God, to have pleasure and to have purpose in God. And we just tell you to stand back and to stand off. In Jesus' name, Lord, we ask that your ministering angels would just stand around them or protect them until the day of their salvation. And, Lord, we just ask, oh God, Lord, that you would cause them, Lord, to come running unto you, running to the cross, running to the blood of Jesus Christ, your precious Son. In Jesus' name, we thank you ahead of time for it, God. And you said wherever two are gathered, two or three or more in your name, God, that there you would be in the midst of them also, Father. So among the hundreds and thousands, and Lord, I don't know how many people are listening, Lord, but among us all, we just say yes, God, and amen to your will. And it's not your will that one should perish, God. So we thank you in Jesus' name for bringing them into the kingdom of God for such a time as this. All right. Thank you. Amen. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We appreciate you, Father, Lord, being there, standing near, God, to perform your word. You told us to remind us of your word, God, to bring it to your attention, God. And we thank you, God. We have faith that you are able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all we could ask, hope, or ever feel, or even think, God, in Jesus' name. And all the saints said, amen. All right. So I sent an email back after I got the thank you email to Miss Ann, and I didn't know this at the time. Ethel Martin's getting ready to come on with this, but I didn't know this at the time. I emailed Ann, and I said, Ann, I said, you know what? God is good. He's got some visions for you. He's shown the prophetess that joins us. He's shown her some things. Can I have your permission? And this is her letter back to me, okay? Anne wrote me and said, Dear God's girl, you may never know in this world what this means to me. I cried when I read your email. She said, I have listened to Ethel twice on your program in your dreams, and both times I prayed from the depths of my heart, Oh Lord, please, one day let it be possible for this wonderful daughter of yours to have a vision from you for me. It would mean the world to me. And then Anne says, it seems so utterly impossible, though, as I knew I could not phone in for this. She said, God is truly the God of the impossible. This is a miracle. I am so touched and humbled and excited all at the same time, Anne said. How can I ever thank you enough for being a part of this miracle in my life? She says, I don't mind. It's an honor to be a part of your blessed program. So this is the part that floored me, okay? Anne's over there, I help her with her dream, and she's over there praying that one day she could get a word from Ethel. I didn't know that, and I didn't tell Ethel the fullness of her dream or her dream interpretation until after the visions came. So Anne, drum roll, I wish I had a drum roll here, but Anne, God heard your prayer, and he loves you, and here is your word from Prophetess Ethel Martin. Okay, we're going to start off with you, and then God goes in and he continues to give visions to Ethel for other listeners. So hold on, listeners. Okay, if you're in need of something, stay tuned and just listen after we give Anne her word, and then God will reveal visions and revelation about things for the other listeners. So I hope you're blessed. It's a blessing for me to be a part of contributing into your spirit. I do not take it lightly. This is nothing to play around with. You can't say God said something if he didn't say it. That's not a price that I want to pay. So believe me when I say, Prophetess Ethel, she is the real thing. She is a woman of honor. She is a woman who serves the Lord, and she is unmovable and she is steady. Not to say that we all can't be moved, but I'm just saying I esteem her in very high regards, and I don't have her on this show lightly. So I just want you to know that, okay? So here we go. I'd like to welcome you into this prophetic session of In Your Dreams. God bless you. And here we are. We're going to start off with Prophetess Ethel Martin. Welcome to In Your Dreams, Ethel. How are you doing?
Fine. Praise the Lord. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you so much for being on the show again.
My pleasure.
Oh, that's sweet. Remember I was telling you about that girl that
helped with a dream, and she had, her name is Anne. She had a dream that she was in this white house, and I was getting ready to tell you about part of the dream, and you stopped me, and God was giving you some visions for her. So I wanted you to share, if you wouldn't mind, because she lives in the UK, and she is not able to call in. And I really feel like God wants us to bless her with these visions that he's given you. And I know that you feel that way too, right?
Yes. Praise the Lord.
Amen. This is so exciting.
Yes, it is.
God is so good. He cares about the people that can't call in.
That's right.
Who knows? He may give us something else for some other people listening out there. But I remember you starting off with the vision that she had when she was in bed. So would you share that? And this is for you, Anne. We know that you're listening. I want you to know that God loves you and that he's answered your prayer to receive a word.
Isn't it wonderful, Anne, that you know by this response that God for sure hears you, even though you know he hears you, he is just backing up your faith that he does hear you. Praise God. As God's girl was talking about you, God showed me that you were in bed, leaning your back against the headboard of the bed, and you kind of had your knees up in a sitting position. And I could see that someone was under the covers next to you, but I couldn't see any face or anything. It was like their back was to you. And so I don't know if that was your husband or if it is, if he's saved or unsaved, but he was totally covered up. So I kind of took it that he was in the dark or asleep or unsaved. But nevertheless, if it is your husband under the cover, then he is living under your umbrella of prayer for him or whoever it is under that blanket.
Hopefully it's her husband.
I believe it's her husband. But
I'm just playing.
I don't see a face or anything. I just see that there's someone in the bed.
Right. Well, I do know that Ann did share with me on the email that she was married, so I think you're correct. It probably is her husband.
Mm-hmm. All right. That's good. And then God gave me a vision of money coming down on you. I didn't see any change. I saw bills. I didn't see the denominations, just that it was money.
I know if Ann was here, she'd say, hallelujah.
So we'll
I said
it,
that for you, Ann. Money falling on her, that's great.
I don't know when it's coming or how much or anything. God just showed me that he was blessing you with money.
Awesome.
Hallelujah. We always need money to get out and do what God wants us to do.
Mm-hmm. And then the part about the fireworks, you shared that with me.
Yes.
It was another vision.
There's a lot of blessings heading your way, and it's a progressive thing. Like if you go to watch fireworks, and then when they get to the grand finale, they always have one group of fireworks they let off, but there's usually one in the middle of the fireworks as it explodes. That goes higher and expands further out. So God showed me that there is a big blessing coming by showing me those fireworks. Okay? So just enjoy, girl, and get your bag out and get ready to catch them all when they start heading your way.
And I remember you sharing that even though there was a big firework of blessing, like a main one in the middle, that they would be progressive and they would continue.
Right, there won't be any end of God's blessings.
Okay, so tell her the part about the vision that the Lord gave you about the veil.
Oh, my goodness.
I know. We're so excited for you, Anne.
God is so wonderful, and he loves you so much, and he rejoices over you, and he has made abundant provision for you. God showed me a vision of you with a veil over your face, and what that reminded me of was Moses because of the Shekinah glory on his face.
Mm.
And Moses moved in a miracle ministry.
That's right.
And God showed me miracle ministry wrote on your forehead with the veil because of the Shekinah glory. You won't wear a veil, but that was God's way of expressing to me what he was telling me about you and the plans he has for you. And these miracles that God will use you for. Of course, salvation is the first biggest one for anyone, but in the end times, there's going to be arms and legs growed out. Even though they're happening now in different countries, it's going to be phenomenal how God is going to bring these miracles about, like in his day when he was on earth. So, what a joy.
The miracle of wonder working. Like Moses, he worked in wonders.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, science. Mm-hmm. That's awesome. So God's going to use her for that. And that, you said when you were sharing this with me, you said that out of all the people that you'd minister to.
Yes, I only know three people that God has given me the veil over their face and the Shekinah glory. And that's what Moses had when he had to put it over his face to keep him blinding the people. But these miracles will be visual miracles as well as hidden in the end times that nobody can get credit for it. But isn't that exciting that God is preparing you for that? Hallelujah. Girl, I'm going to come over and help you. You don't need any help. You got the Trinity.
And the Shekinah glory is going to be all over you, or the anointing for working miracles. You also said that you saw a cow. This was the last vision, I believe, that God shared with you.
Yes. In the vision, there is a house far in the distance with the grass roof, you know, the thatch roof. And then there was a road going to the house. But at the end of the road, there was someone with boots on, the dirt road, that had a cow coming down the path. The house wasn't the significant part of the vision. It was just God's way of showing me a country road and someone with boots on that weren't buckled
mm-hmm.
with a cow. And I believe what God is saying in the cow, that's provision, because a cow is meat, it's milk. You can sell meat, you can sell the milk. So I just took it as abundant provision for you. It's going to meet all your needs. Praise God.
Wow, that is awesome. Now,
Hallelujah.
Ethel, all this is for Ann Baker, but you have taught before when you shared with me, and I've learned this as well, that when you said when people hear a word, what did you say about the words?
It's for a lot of people. Even though we're speaking with Ann right now, they have handles on this. So if anyone's listening and it witnesses to them that the word's for them, so it is.
That's right. God is no respecter of persons.
So you just reach out and grab it and hold on to it and say, that's mine.
With your faith.
That's right.
Yeah, that's awesome.
That's right.
So but get ready. And you said, let me just interrupt you real quick about mm-hmm. before you go on to the next part, with the part about the miracle working and the glory of God on the Shekinah glory on Anne's face with the veil of Moses, you said that God was, you said that God was taking her through a process.
Yes, a training process.
So there's a training process.
Preparation.
Okay, preparation. So that may be where she's at right now.
To bring you to the place wants to take you to your destiny.
And so we don't put any times on this, but we want you to know that God is moving
yes.
on your behalf and that you are in his thoughts. And like Ethel said, he loves you enough. And the letter that you mailed me just was awesome, how you've been praying that God would use Prophetess Ethel to send you a word. And I didn't know that. And then he did. And so God's listening. He's listening and he's moving on your behalf all the way over there in the UK. So do you have anything else, Miss Ethel?
Yes, there's someone that has a serious stomach problem.
Mm.
And as you reach out and grab this word by faith, God will bless you with your healing and restoration. Okay?
Somebody out there, you know who you are. When you hear that word, grab hold of it. And
even if you're male or female,
right,
it's for you.
Right, so God's showing you somebody with a stomach problem.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Lord, you got any more for us?
Yes, there's someone with, I believe it's a goiter in their throat. And if you reach up there at the right palm of your hand and praise and thank Jesus for it, he's bringing a healing.
Mm, we stand in agreement with that person right now, Lord, in Jesus' name. As they grab hold and lay hands on their throat, that they will be healed, Father, by your word of
yes.
knowledge, God, your word of wisdom.
And someone that has a broken, I believe it's a broken right arm. I know it's a right arm and a cast, and I'm saying it's broken, but it could be someone that's had surgery. I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever it is, God's fixing it right now.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
God, you are awesome. You
praise
are moving God. Tonight. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Praise your
wow.
name.
Wow.
Wow.
Bless your people, Lord. Bless them, God, with words of encouragement, God.
And there's someone, I don't know if it's prison or jail, but I see bars.
Mm-hmm.
And whoever that is that's locked up, God's going to open the door and release you. He gives me a vision of the key going in the lock and the door swinging open. God bless you.
You know me. Do you think that's symbolic of an inward personal prison or more so for somebody really in jail?
It could work either way.
It could be either way. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. So.
Hallelujah. And God bless you. And it's been a treat to share with you and fellowship with you and for the glory of the Lord. And I would say write this down, date it. And
you're talking to the people listening, right?
Mm-hmm.
Write it down, date it.
Mm-hmm. And refer to it from time to time.
Just making sure I can get ready to get a word. You know me. I need to write something down for me. No, it's not all about you, this show.
While we're fooling around here a little bit, God has given me a vision of somebody's ankle, the right ankle.
Mm-hmm.
And it's quite a bit of pain, but just grab onto it. God will heal you right up.
That's right. There's healing in the blood of Jesus.
Mm-hmm. And somebody's got a problem in their inner ear, the deepest part of the ear. And he's fixing that up. It's restoring your hearing.
Wow. Yeah, even though you hear these words, you need to grab hold of it with your faith and say, yes, Lord, that's for me.
Mm-hmm.
I receive that. I believe that.
And there's someone that has a problem with their right eye. And if you will go in and anoint your eye with oil, any kind of oil that you have, olive oil, anointing oil, even sun lotion, close your eye and anoint it in the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, it's going to clear up.
Mm.
Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Awesome.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God.
Awesome, Lord. Is there anybody else you want to speak to, Lord?
Praise you.
We're
Jesus.
Waiting on you, God. It's all about you,
thank
Jesus.
You, Father.
For your glory,
privilege,
Lord.
Privilege, Lord, to be used for your glory.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. There's someone that's praying for their children, and God's given me a vision of a mother duck with these little ducks following along behind in line. So they're all coming in.
Oh, awesome.
They're all coming in to meet Jesus. Praise the
Lord. It's all going to line up. They're coming in line.
I can't say how many they are. I just know there's some little ducks following along behind, one by one, one right after the other.
Mm.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. They look cute, too, those little ducks. All right. And rejoice. Jesus loves you, and I do, too, and it's wonderful meeting a new member of my family, the family of God.
All right. Well, thank you so much for being willing and obedient to call in. God giving you an approval to call into the show and minister to these people.
I like it.
I love it. I love it. This is probably one of my favorite parts of the show. Because, you know, there was such a long time where there was a dry season in my life. So it's so great just to receive a word. And I know you've been there too.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm sure there are people out there praying that God would speak to them. And there's not really many avenues, I don't think, as far as radio or television-wise for that to happen. So I'm honored to be a part of it.
God bless you.
People out there, keep praying. Mm-hmm. Lord will keep giving you the visions, and Lord willing, when he allows her to, we'll give you the hookup.
Okay.
All right. I'm your host, God's Girl. If anybody out there has a dream or if you have something that you'd like help interpreting, please feel free to send me an email, your short dream, to godsgirl@wrrw.fm. Once again, my email address is godsgirl@wrrw.fm. Thank you, Prophetess Eva, for joining us today.
God bless you.
Look forward to seeing you next time. Bye-bye.
Hello, everyone. I'm your host, God's Girl. Thank you so much for tuning in today. I really hope you enjoy today's show. I want you to know that I consider it an honor and a privilege to come before you each week and share on dream interpretation. I get some requests, what are some good dream books? So I'm going to recommend some, but you're not going to be able to get all the information just from me on this little short blurb here. So go to my webpage. It's www.myspace.com/GodsGirlTV. Once again, it's www.myspace.com/ God's Girl TV, and you can check out the book references that I'm going to suggest to you now. A great book is Herman Riffle. He wrote Dream Interpretation, A Biblical Understanding. He's the patriarch, in my opinion, of dream interpretation, and God really used him to bring dreams and their interpretations into the body of Christ a while back, and he is my mentor, so I highly recommend his book. And then a wonderful book. It's well-rounded, has a lot of examples in there of people's dreams and their interpretations. And that's a book called Dream Dreams by Steve and Diane Bidelight. They're out of Canada. And also, most of you are familiar with Mr. Ira Milligan. I've seen him in person, very anointed, awesome speaker, well-gifted in dream interpretation. He wrote a book called Understanding the Dreams You Dream, Volume 1 and Volume 2. So there's two books. And then the last recommendation is a workbook. It's by Mark and Patty Verkler. It's called Hear God Through Your Dreams. All of these authors are just blessed in dream interpretation, so you can't really go wrong with any of them. If you're like me, I wanted to know what they all said, so I really studied up over here. But anyway, God bless you, and do them a favor. Cut out the middleman. Buy their books straight from them. And so once again, you can find their web pages and the titles of their books on my MySpace. So check it out on MySpace. It's www.myspace.com/godsgirltv. Thank you so much for listening. I'm your host, God's Girl, and I just want to take the time to just remind you, if you're already saved, that's great, that Jesus is Lord. And if you're not saved, you know what? Jesus can be your Lord. All you have to do to be part of God's family is just believe the truth that Jesus died on the cross for all of the world's sin. He shed his blood so that we could have eternal life and live with him forever and be forgiven of being born into this sinful world. So if that sounds really good to you and you're interested in being a part of God's family, all you have to do is just say, Lord, you know what? I never really thought about it too much, but I've heard this truth and I want to be forgiven and I want to accept your free gift of salvation. Lord, please come into my heart, make me a new person, and give me eternal life with you. Thank you for forgiving me of my sins, and I appreciate this free gift. That's all it takes, and you're part of the family of God. Now walk holy, walk upright, live right, try to please him for the rest of your life, and just see if your world is not rocked. God bless you, and welcome to the family.
In Your Dreams is a production of New Horizons 3000. Archive copies of this show are available on the web at www.rrw.fm.